Alrighty guys, for Wednesday, we got 2 to 3 sets for the warm-up. 250 meters rower, preferably if you're doing the rower for a workout, 200 meters bike. If you're running, do the running for the first part of it. Once you're done with that, we're gonna go to 10 bootstrappers. That's just a squat, dropping down, and then hips all the way up. 10, nice and easy, driving the elbows into the knees. Once you're finished, you're gonna go 10 goblet squats, probably with your medicine ball. 10, nice and easy. Then you go into the 10 alternating reverse lunges, so holding that ball. I think I had done with this yesterday. Nice and easy, 10 alternating. And then 45 second plank, you can go low or you can go high, just holding that plank position. For the workout today, it's gonna be a 5K row, or a 5K run if you don't have a rower. Just pick one or the other. The goal behind this is to get the 5K done in 10 sets or less. So you're gonna have to think about in your head, you're gonna strategize your intensity for being able to get this done within those 10 rounds. So what you'll do is you'll start out with either the row, and remember when we're rowing, treat it just like a deadlift. Drive and then pull, drive and then pull. If you're running, just pick a nice easy stride, but remember consistency with those 10 rounds. Once you get to a 3 minute mark, you either time it with your watch or a timer on the wall or something, you're gonna go into 6 med ball cleans. Or you can also do 6 wall balls, by the way, too. So med ball clean, remember, labels facing forward, high pull, drop underneath. If we don't have that, body weight version is gonna be lunge into squat. That's one rep, you'll still do 6 total. So 6 med ball cleans or 6 wall balls, and then or lunge squat. That's one round. You want to try to accomplish those 5Ks or 5K row within 10 rounds. If you exceeded and the intensity wasn't pushed as much as it could have been. So yeah, just try to plan in your head what you're going to do for that. Accessory work is going to be 90 seconds pigeon stretch. I use the bench for this, and especially if you have mobility problems. And you don't want to go all the way down, you can't go all the way down, bench is a good alternative for it. So 90 seconds one side, then you'll do your 90 seconds on your other side. Once you're done, you'll do 3 sets of 6 tempo reverse or chest flies. So you'll grab your dumbbells, and you're going to count to 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then come in fast and squeeze. Then you'll do 6 more. Oh, I'm sorry, 5 more reps. Once you're done with your 3 sets of 6, you'll then do 1 set of 90 seconds of banging lat stretch. Wrap around the wrist, then grab it. Then you're going to stretch your lat. Remember, it's through here, 90 seconds one side, 90 on the other. Then you're going to finish with 3 sets of 6. With that 6 seconds lower tempo of a Cossack squat, you're gonna ideally use weight for this. Kettlebell, dumbbell, whatever you wanna use for it. Wide stance, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Then you'll do the other side. 3 sets of 6. Give yourself about 60 seconds rest in between each set.